Welcome back, Fox Tools. I'm Tom, and welcome back to the Project Egress Build series.
All right, these next ones, these are actually a little challenging here. That's these angle brackets here. These are monolithic. This is all one piece here, up to this point here. So this top frame is a three-piece weldment. It was just too much to do it in one piece. And I suspect by looking at the pictures of the originals that that's exactly how the original guys made this too, is they made it in three pieces. But these are stainless steel, and this is a long reach with a radius, a large radius in the corner there. So there were some challenges with that, but you guys are going to get to see me get challenged on that. So let's go see how I did that. Now you gotta love a roughing or corn cob end mill for ripping material out of there. This took, I don't know, 10 or 15 minutes, something like that total, to get that out of there in a few steps. Obviously this isn't the finished surface, but it's removed most of the material and gotten out of my way. You can still see my little scribe lines here, my layout lines. And we'll come back with a finishing end mill and clean that all up and make it really look nice. So, and I'm using these are talon jaws here for folks that are not familiar with those. They got a little stop and talon jaws, and what they do, there you can see it there, is they actually really bite into the material almost like a dovetail, and they're extremely secure, let's just put it that way, when you want to have kind of minimal grab stock to work with. You see this a lot in the CNC work. In fact, that's where these came from when I used to do a fair amount of that. These are pretty handy for just grabbing a little bit of material and being real secure. So well, there's one, and here's the other one. That's what it started out. I drilled out the intersections, undersize there, and you can see the remaining part of that hole there. And then went in with this coarse pitch roughing end mill. So, all right, let's keep going here. Went surprisingly well. I was worried that it was squeaking in the corner, but it's really, this will a little bit of Scotch-Brite will take out the any marks that are there, so I'm pretty pleased with that that result. And especially kind of hanging out of the vise like that, that's not as optimal. I mean, if there was mass on the back, it might have damped it a little more, but that's not bad. I stepped down. I was stepping down 100 thousandths at a time, and then I was getting tired of that. So I took a half inch, and it actually behaved itself better. So I kind of increased the Z depth of engagement. So. Center drill it. right? Doing, I'm trying to blend, get a really good tight blend with that line with this corner here. That's what I was looking for there. So that. Thank you. These are these Norton Blaze strip and clean discs. I actually really like them for blending scratches and stuff like that. They work really well, kind of across the board, and they last like a long time. It's a ceramic abrasive, I think. That works good for stuff that where you have a surface there you want to conform to. Still a little bit warm. I'm letting it get cold before I pop it out of the fixture, and I may have to do a little bit of straightening to make sure that the hole centers are correct so that it lines up with its mate in Washington, D.C. Come on.